In this example, we are given the two large parallel plates. A and B are given charges 10 microcoulomb and 20 microcoulomb, as we can see in the figure. And it is saying if area of each plate is S, we are required to find the charge distribution on all surfaces of the plates and electric field strength at points X, Y and Z. So in this situation, we know well that in a system of parallel large plates, charge distribution is such that on the outer surfaces, the charges are equal and that is the half of the total magnitude of the charge. So here say if the distribution of charges are Q1, Q2, Q3 and Q4, then here we can say Q1 is equals to Q4 is equals to 10 plus 20 by 2. That will be plus 15 microcoulomb. That will be the charges which are distributed on the outer surfaces of both of these plates. And we can see that Q2 and Q3 must be equal and opposite. So here we can say if Q1 is plus 15 microcoulomb and the total charge on plate A is 10 microcoulomb, then by conservation of charge we can say that Q2 must be equal to minus 5 microcoulomb. Similarly on the other plate, as it has to be equal and opposite, or we can say total charge on plate B is 20 microcoulomb and Q4 is plus 15. So we can say Q3 will be plus 5 microcoulomb charge. So these are the answer to first part of the problem. And here we are also required to find the electric field strength at points X, Y and Z. As Q1 is positive, we can say that electric field at point X will be toward left in between the two plates. As Q3 is positive, Q2 is negative, electric field at point Y will again be in leftward direction. And as Q4 is positive, it will be in rightward direction EZ. The magnitudes, we know that in front of metal sheet, whenever there is a surface charge distribution, electric field can be given as sigma by epsilon naught. So electric field at point X can be written as Q1 by S, that will be the surface charge density on the face A or the face which is in front of the point X of plate A, then it can be written as sigma by epsilon naught. So the value will be 15 by S epsilon naught and it will be in leftward direction. Electric field at point Y can be given as the face of plate which is in front of the point Y is carrying a charge Q3. It can be written as Q3 by S upon epsilon naught. So this will be 5 by S epsilon naught. Similarly, EZ can be written as it will be in front of the charge face on which charge is Q4. So it will be Q4 by S upon epsilon naught, which will be again as Q4 is 15 microcoulomb, it will be 15 by S epsilon naught. So these are the electric fields at the points X, Y and Z due to the charge distribution on the two plates.